For this practice, let's say you receive an equation like right here. A common question or set of questions may be, what is this? How is it used? If the SSD that is new is higher, what would you expect of this factor? How do you usually and actually tangibly use this factor? And in what scenarios would this method work poorly? So what we have here is the Mayneord factor. And so it applies to percent depth dose curves at different SSDs. So it essentially changes the difference in the inverse square law term. So if the new SSD is higher, what would you expect of this factor? So if the new SSD, which is SSD2, if that is greater than our original SSD, this factor, which I'm going to call F here, is going to be greater than 1. Now, if SSD2 is less than SSD1, the Mayneord factor is less than 1. So thankfully, it is easy to remember because if it's higher, it's going to be greater than 1. So this shows that the percent depth dose increases with SSD. That also helps you keep that relationship in check as well. So how do you actually use this factor? So you have your two different SSDs and your depths and your D maxes. And so when you plug all those in for your two different treatment regimes, you're going to gain this F factor here. You're going to multiply this F factor to the percent depth dose of your curve. And that is going to give you the percent depth dose at your new curve, at your new SSD. And in what scenarios does this work poorly? So it overestimates with increases in percent depth dose and SSD. And then it's also bad for large fields and low energies. So you have to be very aware for those. And other than that, Mayneord factor is a tried and true method. Obviously, now we have programs that will do this for us. But quick, easy question, something that could be asked on part 3. Be sure you know the Mayneord factor and how to use it clinically. If you have any questions, please comment below.